Okay, it's clear now or no?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Okay. But in use case, sometimes we can break down to create the detail in detail use detail use case because there is a two kind use case. Overview and detail, and also real and only some important function. Maintain available rental unit can be break down into add apartment and also delete apartment. This is similar like boarding house in President University, and this is apartment owner can add and delete. But sometimes it's okay if you only draw this. This is the next diagram called activity diagram. This is the continuation from the use case. You have to understand that use case only draw the what the system do, and we need another diagram to depict how the system, how the function do it. So we need activity diagram. In short, for easy, it is like the flowchart, but you have to consider that the activity is the easy version or simple version of flowchart. You see, in flowchart, we use start here to draw rectangle with stop, but we use the dot cycle, cycle with the other field side cycle here. And if you want to draw using the pen and paper, it's more easy. You just create back here, and then this is a stop. This is for flowchart. Yeah, so you have to know the difference between activity diagram and flowchart. Inside this use case, if you want to know how the apartment owner at apartment, we need another diagram, activity diagram, for example, to draw capture location. And then the owner capture number of bedroom, capture monthly rent, and then finally at apartment. And for the red apartment, the owner do some activity. Start, capture apartment identifier, and delete apartment. This is the sample from Roni Satriawahono, use case. This is the ATM. Sorry, it's still in Indonesian. This is the user and this is the admin. Admin is the bank officer. In setting card, choose transaction, logout. And when choosing transaction, there is choice. Extend is choice. Include should be appear after this use case run. Insert PIN ID. And then this is the
Oke. Okay.
activity diagram. Start. This is there is a swim lane. This is the user and this is the you see there is a boundary here, system ATM. There is an actor here called internal actor, but do not depict, yeah, do not draw in this diagram because it's internal. So there is an actor actually that shape all this, yeah, called system ATM. So this is the system ATM, and this is user inside the card, and then system ATM system validate the card, and then is it valid or not? There is a decision, yeah, similar to flowchart. It is important because if you have already know the flowchart when study learn about activity diagram, there is some mistake, yeah, because the similar diagram, but there is a difference, yeah. For example, in this diamond symbol, in flowchart we have write the answer inside the diamond. There's a question here is inside the diamond. For example, X. This is the flowchart, and this is if yes, and if there's no here, and there is a branch here. But the designer of activity diagram said there is a problem if we draw like this, yeah, because if the question is long here, we have to draw a white large diamond here and difficult, yeah. And also there is two branch here, but in activity diagram we only have the same symbol size, the same size. We do not need to enlarge or make this small like this. We only usually there is no text here, yeah, but only the in the output. For example, this is yes. So this is we have draw this. This is very simple because we are only draw this, yeah. So if X below 3 go there, if no, yes, this is the another option, yeah. This is the if you want to see the standard, you can searching the without if you want to avoid the debate, you can follow the standard. Current spec, you can see the current spec. This is the specification. You see there is a version 2.5.1. So today unified modeling language have come to the 2.5.1 version. Activity diagram, ya. Nah, dari se jadi we can go to example. So this the current standard of activity diagram. So we draw from left to the right, yeah, for the new version of activity diagram, yeah. Because 5 years ago I learned that they draw from up to bottom, yeah. This is from left to the right, but they have the same symbol. And for decision in diamond, we do not need to ask the question for decision. We only draw the answer, order accept. So you see, if using a flowchart, you need to give the question. Is order accepted? And it's yes, and this is no. But in activity diagram, we only need the answer, yeah, order accepted. Of course, that this is not accepted. If order accepted, there is an activity here, and you see, this is the fork, yeah. Maybe there is another explanation. Maybe the class diagram, I will explain the class, yeah, class explanation, and later the class is similar with the table, but using inside the table there is a operation. So this is the code, the class diagram. For example, the student class, we have a class called student. For class we need not only table but also one or more function for the student. For example, create, add student, edit student, delete student, and read student. So in class there is a attribute is similar to table, name, ID, address, GPA, etc. This is attribute. Or in table is field, yeah, or column. In the class kalau attribute. And also we in the class there is another addition function, yeah. Add or new, ya, yeah. Delete, update, and read. This is but it is similar, ya, yeah. Why there is a function inside the table for object? Because the object concept do not separate object with attribute and function. For example, human, we do not only know the name, address, and etc., but also the ability, how is the man walk, run, and do some function. So this is the object concept. Can we create the class without function? Yeah, of course we can. We can still say that this is the class, but without function. But can we say that table as a class? No, because table cannot store the function in a table or in a relational database, yeah. We can store the function in a table, yeah. Next, this is the another case study. The library. This is the specification of the software library book collection management system. There is five use case, and there is two actor. The size of the software can be seen by see the number of use case and also the number of user. If a lot of user inside this system, is the big the size of the software, yeah, because there is a lot of rule inside the actor. Okay, this is only have two actor, librarian and borrower. Okay, if you want to see the standard of activity, activity as already. Oh, rock can join me. Okay, this is the fork. This is not division, yeah. For example, is X. This is X, and this is also X. This is the same. It's only flow in different location, yeah. So nothing click, and also in the same time shipping order, yeah. Order, and then accounting click, send the invoice, and you see this is the symbol external. This is the standard AML for make payment, and this is the another location, yeah. Accept payment, and then this is the join, yeah, fork and join. In join, two flow have directly at the same time do the next activity, close order, and then the activity stop here. This is for use case, yeah. Already discussed maybe last week, yeah. This is the standard. In the use case, there is a multiplicity. This is the call the multiplicity. If you read this diagram, one customer can do zero withdrawal, zero or only one withdrawal, zero and one. This is bank, yeah. One bank can do no deposit or can infinity deposit, yeah. So every bank can register a lot of ATM, yeah. Zero or do not, yeah. Zero to infinity, yeah. This is called the multiplicity. One, two, three, four, five. So for the analysis, this analysis step in SDLC, yeah. After use case, you have to draw every use case with another diagram to see how the system doing this activity or this use case, yeah. For example, how the system to process over the book, yeah, by a librarian, how to maintain book using the activity diagram, and also another diagram called sequence, yeah. Jadi I will add a slide with this, with sequence diagram ya, urutan sequence. This is sequence diagram. This is a oh, the for sequence diagram is not too detailed. Only you have to give the name of the music, and also there is a row here, and this is the formal gate, and this is the lifeline. You have to the lifeline. This is not the sequence, and this is only the syntax, syntax of the because UML is unified modeling, not diagram. You have to have make the difference between model and diagram. Diagram only the picture for explanation, but model should have the semantic, syntax and semantic, similar with language, modeling language. Sequence diagram. Okay, we see sequence. Yeah, this is the sequence diagram. Every use case should be is draw by the sequence. Of course, you have to choose sequence or activity diagram. It's they have their own strong and weakness. Okay, we want to send money, for example. This is the transfer. Maybe in the first time you will be confused or difficult to read what is the diagram. Mean, what is the meaning of this diagram? We see from the UML standard there's a lifeline. This is the lifeline. There is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 lifeline. And there is a symbol here. This is called the boundary. You see the boundary, or in reality, this is form or menu or interface. This is the interface. So, an analyst create the sequence. Because this is useful for the programmer, so there is a division between an analyst and programmer. So the programmer should create main menu here. This menu utama, main menu. After they successfully log in or insert a pin menu. In the main menu, the user choose send or transfer, and then this main menu will show the transfer money menu. The next, I think ATM is not good for UI. User interface, but it's simple the only clicking. So the transfer money menu, and then the user input account target receiver account, receive account, and then also input another amount of money ya, amount, and then sorry, actually this is here ya. This is called a controller or a process ya. Process. This process will handle every enter ya, enter execution ya. After insert receiver account and then some money, submit, okay, and then this is we need here. Because there is a big use case and simple use case and medium, yeah. So if there is a lot of process, it means that the use case is complex, yeah. You see, in this use case, there is only one process. This is a process, a send money process, yeah. This is the simple use case. How to send money by, this is called entity, or in the reality is a table, yeah. Account table. For example, student database, student data, and course data. So this is the table or we call it entity. Get an ID from the account or target, yeah. And then we have to check the saldo. This is the table also similar like this. The table about our balance. If the saldo is enough, it's okay. But if there is no saldo inside this user balance, yeah, cannot continue. And also, if there is a saldo, we have to count the saldo after minus, yeah, after send, yeah. And then we update the our balance in our bank, yeah. And after the process, we still in transfer menu show the result, yeah, success or fail, yeah. So if we are a programmer, we will draw the main menu, and then we draw the menu for transfer, and then we have to query about the account and balance, and then we compare with the money that have to be sent. If enough, we get calculation, ya, out balance with the money, ya. Maybe there is other, for example, another fee, ya, this year, if there is a fee, and etc. This is the sequence, ya. So this is the here, yeah. This is the use case for send money, yeah. This use case will be draw using this sequence. Actually, for the newer version, we do not need draw this symbol, yeah, because all using the rectangle standard here, yeah. Only rectangle and rectangle. Okay, we continue to this library. One exhibit case study to where is it? This is the use case for Borrow ya, yeah. I think this is borrow. This is the activity diagram for borrow book, borrower. Validate, check the card, and then if card is valid, you see there is no question here, only the reserve. If there is overdue books and fines for the borrower, if no overbook, you can borrow the book, check out books. But if there is fines and overdue book, you do not allow to borrow. Then we stop here. So you have to fix this. Yeah, give back your borrow book and then go to the library again and do this activity. This is for borrowing book activity. Usually in implementation, not all the use case draw in activity or sequence, ya. Yeah. Usually this is for only for the important use case. For example, written books, maybe we only need similar like this, and then another activity. Of course, it's good if you draw this all this use case using the another diagram, ya, activity diagram or sequence diagram. And then this is the class diagram for the library. So if you see this, you only need to understand that in implementation, this is the table in database, for example, in Access, MySQL, Oracle, Microsoft SQL Server, and etc. This is on the table, but there is some function for every class. So a class diagram have three compartments: the name, attribute, name, ID, address, and etc. Attribute or field in table. And also have the function, not mandatory, yeah. If there is a no function, it's okay for a class, yeah. Because there is some class called abstract class, and this only create the menu, yeah. This is there is a symbol here. This is called generalization. You see there is a journal, DVD, book, other media. It's a member of a media. For example, lecturer, student, rector, etc. is a member of person. Yeah. For example, if there is a, we need to do some general. Choose the media. Of course, if you do not need to do some manipulation for all media, the same manipulation, we do not need this class. We only draw this. And there is a location, dari book location, and another class diagram related to the location, etc. Also, and there is the aggregation here. Aggregation, there is a tree, yeah. Component, aggregation, and component aggregation, yeah. Component similar with in mechanical engineering, yeah. Component in a car, for example, there is a wheel, body, engine, and etc. Component. If the car, I delete the car, also the wheel, the body and engine is also delete. It's just the component. But for aggregation, usually if the main is delete, the part is still existing. Librarian and etc. This is difficult for the non-programmer. So the use the CEO or the user is usually understand the use case, but for the next diagram, for example class diagram, they difficult to understand. But for the beginner, you only need to know that there is a, in a database, this is a table, and also there is a function here, because an object concept separate, do not separate the function with the table. Okay, this is maybe will make you more understand, but the object. For example, I have table here. For example, student. There is an ID and name here. In non-object, there is a function here. If I press the button, this function, for example, adding a student, will in SQL structured query language, insert ID, NM, etc. into this table. This is the structure non-object. For the object, we do not use this method. We only use this button, and we have to create this function, add function, using the, this is the symbol bracket. So if there is a button to insert a new student, we only give a message. This is called a message. The message is contain to use the add function with the ID and name here. So you see there is no coding for insert SQL here, because the insert SQL is inside the add function here. So you see that this second method, this object is more more safe, because you see the SQL injection hacker using can go to the table using the SQL injection, using the, but for the object, the SQL is inside this class, so using this class, there is a function here. You see, for example, in you go to the doctor because you ill, and after doctor check your body, and then they give for here doctor give you a obat, drug, directly after check the body, and this is the doctor only create some recipe contain the drug that you have to get, yeah. And then they only message, give the message the doctor to the here, and then the apothecary, yeah, will apothecary will get the drug to you. Yeah. This is the different. So if there is a problem when sending the message, you can use this message again, yeah, to change this message into the drug. Yeah. This is only for the example. This is called the object, yeah, here. What is the useful? Because there is an encapsulation. Encapsulation is a capsule, yeah. Outside this class, environment cannot influence the class, yeah, because encapsulation. So if this outside want to add a new student, then only get the message, and then this function can do the similar like this. But of course there is some additional function, for example check the validation, check the security and etc., and also check the standard here and etc., and also some limitation to secure. And then if you want to use this object to another system, we can just copy paste here to the new system, yeah, called the reuse. Reuse is the concept of object, because after we copy paste, we don't need to program it again, because every function here is available inside this class. Yeah. Of course, maybe in the reality, in implementation, there is a combination. Maybe there is an object, full object, and also there is some object using the non-object, yeah, go together, because current database management system usually do not accommodate the class, yeah, to store table and then also the function. Yeah. But some object database, for example, MongoDB, the famous one, can store, yeah, the attribute and also the function. So DB4O, ZODB, this is also the object database. This is usually for Python, and this is for Java, and etc. Okay, we can continue the case study number 3. This is for the doctor appointment system. And there is we have already discussed, yeah, 3 use case. Also there is actually 3 actor, but there is a generalization here. In patient, there is a new patient. New patient actually have the same attribute, same function with patient, but there is specification here. So this is general and this is specific. New patient, there new additional, yeah, function. Yeah. Patient, we have to convert new patient and old patient. For old patient, new patient, we separate new patient appointment and old patient appointment, because for new patient this is include, yeah, if this is run, and also this also have to run, yeah, must be run, yeah, here create new patient, so we have register, yeah. For example, if you go to YouTube, you can also register, but and also do not register, yeah. But for this new patient, you have to register. Without registering, you cannot, you are not allowed to make appointment. And then after create new patient, it become the same status with our patient here to manage appointment. And for old patient also we can update because something maybe for example address etc. there is a chance it can should be update. And in manage appointment there is a choice. You see this is the extent the flow is from the child to the main. You see there's a difference here. Include is for the main to the child, extend to the from child to the main because this is only option. You can make payment arrangement or not, yeah. And after this, this is not stop here because inside the boundary there is an internal system or internal actor here that accommodate this to other use case, yeah. So for example this is the management. Management is external because he or she do some click yeah, some activity manually yeah, write the schedule. If the schedule is automatically full yeah, fully automatic, the management is delayed because management is its internal actor here yeah. Of course, this is only for automatic ya. For example, in ATM, in ATM, the teller is delete because the teller is inside the ATM, so they automatically do some process ya. But if in office, bank office ya, of branch ya, we see there is a teller. The teller is outside the system because the teller is doing some activity for the system ya, yeah. In setting, click transfer and etc. Yeah, it means that management is not inside the system but outside ya. Yeah. They can produce schedule manually ya, yeah. Yeah, click. You see they produce schedule with fire the other is include. Just automatically run after this run schedule, manage schedule. Also for the doctor, record available. So this is automatically open this discuss and manage schedule the same actor accessing the same discuss. So in sequence or in activity there is a timeline ya yeah, for this to act to active to actor. And this is the class diagram for the appointment medical appointment system. For easy we minimum have some table actor ya, data table about management, table doctor, table of patient, there is patient, patient there is yes patient ya, and also management, where is the management. Actually, maybe there is a different name, employee maybe, ya, employee. And you see there is also the multiplicity here. Account and entry. One account can do a lot of entry, ya, 0, 3. And there is the direction. You see, but so the account go to here ya, do has entry, and also appointment this can make easy to see the flow ya, appointment assigned to doctor. This is in appointment, where is the appointment, maybe this is here ya. There's a doctor table here. Management, I think this is receptionist. Receptionist. Also, no receptionist here, maybe. Do only register. There's a medical history, treatment also, maybe at some table here to some service. Yeah. Plus good transaction line item appointment has. And this is the detail is in the database, yeah. Of course. Yeah. And also there is object, object, there is class diagram, and also there is a object diagram. Yeah. Object diagram is mean that, for example, this is the class, yeah, I teach in industrial engineering class. In class, there is a lot of object. Maybe there is 29 student go in this gym. Yeah. 29 student. Maybe there is a 30 student in this class. In this class. But sometimes we have to draw the object only one. This is only one. This is the object, yeah. This class. Spatial, this is the object. You have to write. A patient. This is appointment. And this is the symptom. And Dr. Smith. The object diagram is usually important for game, yeah. Game. For example, in PUBG, yeah, maybe you have or a Mobile Legend. Maybe easy to understand by using the object diagram. For example, you choose one slot, and also, for example, you saw another. What's mean ya? Object ya. Maybe there is a different ya, different specification. Sometimes they have some function but have different action. For example, if you choose the fish, for example, if there is a button run, they will swim. Swim. For people, maybe running, running. For bird, maybe flying. And this is the what is mean? I forget. Same function but different realization. Yeah, this is also important concept in object data object concept. Yeah. Okay, we continue. Actually, this is for the next mini project, yeah, after mid exam. So okay, I will discuss later about the another concept, next week about the non-object. EFD and ERD, yeah. But this is this slide is useful. This is the important diagram in UML. So you can see the Diagram diagram and element. Yeah. Oh, sorry. UML diagram. Here, ya. This is diagram of UML 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Eight, 18 maybe ya. We separate between structure diagram and behavior diagram. The structure diagram is static, so class diagram, table and component diagram, object diagram, composite deploy, profile, and also another diagram is behavior diagram. We have learn use case, activity, and also sequence. And sequence diagram is inside the interaction diagram, a sequence with the overview and timing communication. This is the famous diagram. You need to understand use case. Use case and activity or sequence. And then class diagram. One, two, three. One, two, three. This is the for the conventional application. Yeah, but for gaming, etc., maybe the timing diagram and communication diagram. State machine is also useful if there is some object change. Yeah. For example, a patient after treatment, they health or sick and etc. Health patient, for example, COVID, yeah, COVID-19, the after isolation, ya, yeah, isolation, and then they change become the negative, ya. Yeah. So you should use this state machine diagram for if there is a change of an object. Okay, I think enough for today lesson. I will start to capture your attendance. Oh, 41 student.
Hello, sir. Sorry, I want to ask.
Yes.
For the technical mid exam, is it theoretical or practical, sir?
Yeah, there is a two version, ya. Yeah. Theoretical and some simple, ya, yeah, simple like the PowerPoint that I have shared to you. Maybe I will send you a use case and you have to create the activity or sequence, yeah, for the use case. This is for the application, practice, yeah, practice. And so for the theory, maybe there is some online quiz. You have to log in to the online quiz and answer the multiple choice in every question have time limit, maybe 1 minute or half minute.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, I think enough. Thank you for your attention and good evening, ya. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.